Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your extremely most favorite brother from another mother. Hallelujah. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. It is a blessing and an honor to speak with you tonight or today, whatever time it may be, when you might see this. Hallelujah. The miracle of on-demand videos. Hallelujah. What a time to be alive. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Look at all the negative things going on in the world, which is also true, you know, the technology to blow up the world and whatever else is going on in the world. But we can also look at the good things that's going on. And the good things is that we can communicate with people for free all around the world, like Skype, Facebook, talk to people through Facebook, even if you can say all kinds of bad stuff about Facebook. But we can talk for free. The internet's full of porn. But yet, you can also study the Bible. You can use the Google and look up any kind of Bibles, terms, etc., and do a deep study on the Word of God. Hallelujah. So, it is the best of times and the worst of times. Hallelujah. To quote from a famous book, besides the Bible, it is the best of times and the worst of times. It's a tale of two cities. But that's absolutely true, brothers and sisters. Praise God. So, let's thank the Lord right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Lord God, that we can look at the two cities, the tale of two cities. We can look at the world from the negative, or we can look at it by accentuating the positive of the kingdom of God. Father, the positive news is we've read the back of the book and we win through you, Lord Jesus. You win, Lord. Hallelujah. You return to destroy those who are destroying the earth. Hallelujah. Praise God. We've got the victory through your name, Father. We worship you and we praise you right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask you to pour out your spirit on all who will watch this video right now in the name of Jesus. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in us as it is in heaven. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hallelujah, Lord, as we receive our daily bread right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Lord, magnify thy name, Lord God. Father, magnify thy name in this place in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah in Jesus' name. Jesus Christ is risen and the work's already done. Praise the Lord. He can work with those who praise him. Praise the Lord. For God inhabits praise. Praise the Lord. He can work with those who praise him. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. For God inhabits praise, praise the Lord. Yes, for those chains that seem to bind you serve only to remind you they'll drop powerless behind you when you praise him. Hallelujah. You got to lift your voice right now and praise the Lord. You know you got to have that breakthrough. And it begins with raising a hallelujah. Hallelujah means praise Yahweh. Hallelujah. Oh, the devil can't stand it. Hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. Yes. In the presence of my enemies. Hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. Hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. Louder than the unbelief. Hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. Hallelujah. Heaven is on our side. We have victory through the finished work of Jesus Christ. That's the video that the Lord gave me for this Resurrection Sunday that just passed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I just felt led. You know, the Lord had me hold off on sharing it with you. But it is finished. Jesus said from the cross. And just to FYI, the Lord was probably crucified on a Wednesday. Doesn't matter. But they call it Good Friday and say Friday. But no, it was probably a Wednesday in A.D. 31. And my observation and my study in the year was A.D. 31. Where the Feast of Unleavened Bread and the Passover and all that fell together and lined up for the 3 days and three nights for the Lord to be in the ground. It was probably A.D. 31. I've done lots of studying on over the years and years and years. And it's just an FYI. It doesn't matter. I usually don't talk about it because people love to debate and talk about that. That's just an excuse for them to have mental assent to the gospel without having a true relationship with the Lord. When they want to get caught up in all kinds of technicalities and information. Hallelujah. When there's, you know, it's here's Jesus who saved us. And people want to talk about, you know, debate all these little details about, you know, the dates and all that when the Bible doesn't give us the exact dates. Because if God wanted to know us the dates, he would give them to us. In the Old Testament, you see in the Kings and in Chronicles, you see, you know, in the fourth year of King Darius, such and such happened, blah, blah, blah. We can look that up. The chronological historical records, worldly records in the Bible, compare it all together, calculate all that stuff out. We can do all that. But you know, Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. We've got the victory through Jesus. The gospel is not all of those things, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. But the gospel is through Jesus Christ. It's through the living way, a new and living way through Jesus Christ. That's the difference between religion and a personal relationship with Jesus. Religion is a museum. Religion is what happened, you know, 2,000 years ago and all those things. Hallelujah. But Christianity is the great I am. Jesus said, I am. Not I was 2,000 years ago. Not I'm going to be tomorrow. But right now, today, He is the great I am. I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. All those things that the Lord told us. Calling Himself God. Hallelujah. That He is the Son of God. Praise God for that. That Jesus came and died for us. Praise God. We have that victory in Jesus. And He finished it. He paid the price, brothers and sisters. Never forget that Jesus paid it all. Now all to Him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Hallelujah. Jesus did it. We owe all to Him. All to Thee, my precious Savior, I surrender all. Hallelujah. Why? Because we have the victory in Jesus. He saved us. Hallelujah. He sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is due Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. Yes, the Lord sought me and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He sought you and bought you if you're a born-again Christian. Hallelujah. He paid it all. That's why He said on the cross, it is finished. Hallelujah. He finished the work, brothers and sisters. Hebrews chapter 3 and chapter 4. Our rest, our Sabbath rest is in the finished work of Christ. Hallelujah. That's just people running to and fro, trying to follow the Moedim and all those Sabbaths and trying to judge people according to the Old Testament Sabbaths, as it tells us in the New Testament. Let no man judge you according to new moons and, you know, holy days and feasts, you know, the Moedim, these appointed times, these rehearsal, these Sabbaths. Hallelujah. We're judged by one thing, as Jesus said. Do you know me? Hallelujah. Are you born again? That's the way to get into heaven. Jesus said, John 3:3, except a man celebrate and follow the law. No. John 3:3, Jesus told Nicodemus, who was one of the leaders of the Sanhedrin, one of the greatest minds of Israel, who was born somebody. And because he was born somebody, he was somebody in Israel. What did Jesus tell him? Because he said to Jesus, by night, he snuck and talked to Jesus at night so no one would know it, and said, oh, we know you came from God, because nobody can do the things you do except they came from God. And what did Jesus say to him? He cut through all of what Nicodemus was saying and said to him what he needed to hear. A negative way of saying what Jesus said. Your birth didn't get you nowhere with God. Your birth, and because you're somebody in Israel, because you're a great teacher, that none of that is going to get you into heaven. That's a negative way of saying what Jesus said. But Jesus always, God always speaks in a exhortative and a loving way to His people, except for those times of judgment. And what did He say? What did He say? He said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. In other words, as I said, it doesn't matter where you were born the first time or where you came from. Even if you're rich, ruling family, you're some kind of elitist, you can be the president of a country, you can be a congressman, senator, you can be the pope, whoever you are, don't matter. It's your second birth. Hallelujah. Born twice, hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're born twice, you live forever. If you're only born once, hallelujah. Well, that's the saying is, born twice, die once. Born once, die twice. The second death, people going to hell. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Very sad, very sad. We must be born again. So that's the question. Are you born again? Have you been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb? Hallelujah. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Filled with the Holy Ghost, I am. Hallelujah. I'm under the blood. I've been redeemed. Hallelujah. Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb? Hallelujah. Are you washed in the blood? Hallelujah. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Hallelujah. Have you been washed in the blood of the Lamb? That's the question. Are you born again? Hallelujah. How do you know that you're born again? Not because someone spoke it over you, ominous, danous, whatever, sprinkled you, confirmed you, you know, gave you a catechism class, or you got dunked in water, or you got sprinkled with water. That's not what the Bible says. Romans chapter 8 says, His Spirit will bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God. You'll know in your heart from the Spirit of God that you are born again. And then it also says those who are led by the Spirit, these are the children of God. How do you know you're a Christian? Because you're led by the Spirit. You're led by your spirit. The Bible says our spirit, a man's spirit, is a candle of the Lord. So our spirit follows Christ's spirit and leads our body. You know, that's a whole nother thing. Are you led by your flesh? Or are you led by the Spirit? Do you walk according to the flesh or according to the Spirit? It's also talking about trying to follow the law, which I always bring up. So many Judaizers on YouTube versus following the Spirit. But we're talking about, am I led? Does sin rule and reign in my mortal body? As Paul said, don't let sin reign in your mortal body. Hallelujah. Don't let your members be controlled by sin. We once were in those things. Hallelujah. I once was lost in sin till Jesus took me in. And then a little light of heaven flooded my soul. Hallelujah. I can't remember all the words. He wrote my name above. So I find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. So let's have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. So when you feel a little prayer wheel turning, know a little fire is burning, you'll find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Hallelujah. Praise God. Yeah, I just got reminded. I sang that song in a video about 6 months ago, and someone came on there talking about some Hindu stuff. Brothers and sisters, the man who wrote that song, hallelujah, was a black man in Alabama. I talked about this before, who wrote that song to raise money for his church. The church had no money. They said, hey, if we can write some, the Lord would give us a song to write. They would bring money so we can fix our church up. Then the Lord gave him that song. And it had nothing to do with about no Hindu stuff, about no prayer wheel. He's talking about the wheels turning in your mind, the gears turning in your mind. Get your mind out of the flesh. Like I say, stop thinking all this negative, just imagining what people mean. That has nothing to do with what that song means. Those people had no idea about no Hindu. In the 1930s in Alabama, they didn't know nothing about no New Age Hindu and all that kind of stuff that people think about today. Their minds wasn't in the gutter like yours. They weren't in the flesh like you are. They weren't just taking everything in a negative light like that. You know, they had innocence. You know, they had back in those days before all the demonic hippie junk, that commie hippie stuff that happened in the United States in the 1960s. They didn't have all the wacky ideas like people do. They hadn't experienced the Beatles, who brought in the Maharishi, whatever it is called there, brought in the Maharishi doctrine and yoga and all that. Introduced to the Beatles. They're the ones who brought that to the United States. I wrote about that in the book. You know, the 1960s is a turning point for the downfall of the United States. The downfall of the United States. And that's why when old Trump says, make America great again, that's what he's talking about. Going back to those days of innocence, when the biggest problem in schools was people chewing bubble gum and running and shouting in the hallways instead of shooting each other. That's what's wrong with this old devil world. They can't understand that. Because they wanted prayer out of school. They wanted God out of school. And then they wonder why they tell the kids that they evolved from a monkey and that survival of the fittest, and, you know, there's nothing after this. There's no judgment by a supreme being. And then they wonder why people are killing each other and all that. Well, and the people that are without hope, these kids that are doing that are hopeless. And then they've been put on dope. You know, they put all the kids on Ritalin and all that stuff too. This is all part of the post 1960s, you know, the post, this is all the hippie revolution right here, New Age revolution, and now it's go to the next level all the way to the Antichrist. That's what it's going to. Hallelujah. But Jesus already paid the price and finished it for us, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. My spirit, man, has been redeemed. Even though I'm walking around in this hippie, commie, loser, lost people, but my spirit belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. In the eyes of God, I am one of His children. Praise God, because Jesus paid it all for me. Hallelujah. When God looks down, He sees the blood of the Lamb on me. He sees the blood. That angel of death and judgment passes right over my head. Hallelujah. And over every one of you that's covered in the blood of Jesus. When the angel of death passes over, he sees the blood on the doorpost of our hearts. And we are free. We are free. We are clear of the judgment of God. You better go read the word. We have the judgment seat of Christ for our rewards in heaven, brothers and sisters. The Bema seat of Christ, as the Greek says. The judgment seat of Christ. Nothing to do with the great white throne judgment for those who are lost and without hope in this world. Those who are not born again. Totally different things, brothers and sisters. Two different kinds of judgments. Don't let anybody mix you up with that. If you're truly born again. Now, there's lots of false converts. There's lots of false converts. And then sometimes you don't know it. Sometimes it gets manifest. As Jesus said, let the tares and the wheat grow together. So you won't damage the wheat when you're destroying the tares. But there are lots of people who are false converts before, and now, you know, they've exposed themselves because now they come out and say, well, you know, I'm an atheist or whatever. I have relatives that did that. I was there when they got saved. I was there when they got baptized, and then now they're atheists. So false converts, they fell away from, you know, theologians would say they lost their salvation. Other theologians would say they were false converts. That's the kind of arguments I'm talking about. What difference does it make? That person's on the way to hell. That person's under the wrath of God abides on them. It doesn't matter. All this stuff. That's why a lot of these people aren't, you know, in Christianity, because all this religious debate. Brothers and sisters, God is a living God. That's why we call Him the Great I Am. He's right now in this moment with us. The only reason why we look back, what does the Bible tell us? It tells us that the people that we read about in the Bible, like Moses and Noah and whomever, Apostle Paul, whoever you want to look at, they're an example for us. The mistakes that King David made, the mistakes that Noah made, the good things that Noah did, the good thing that Moses did, the mistakes that Moses made. All of these are examples for us, and we can see how to interact with God, what pleases God, and how to move and operate in accordance with God's will. That's what that's all about. We're not living back there. As a famous preacher from Florida says, who's actually from South Africa, he said, people love to keep singing that song, "These Are the Days of Elijah." And he said, let Elijah eat your heart out. Hallelujah. We've got the Holy Spirit in us that Elijah can only dream of. The Holy Spirit came upon people in the Old Testament for special things that God did. We have the Holy Spirit without measure. The New Testament, John chapter 3, says that the Spirit of Christ is without measure for Christ. Hallelujah. The New Testament, brothers and sisters. So what Elijah did, all Christians could do that and more. As it says, the prayers of a righteous man availeth much, referring to Elijah and for us Christians. Elijah, it says in James chapter 5, was of like passions as us, but yet, even though he made mistakes, that's what it's saying, even though Elijah made mistakes, the prayers of a righteous man availeth much. Just like Elijah made mistakes, but yet God answered his prayers. The same thing is true with all of us. Hallelujah. We're all God's children. Praise God. Those of us who are born again, we're adopted sons and daughters of God. Jesus paid the way. He finished it. We can never earn the love of God. He has given it to us because we surrendered and answered the call. Jesus said, no man comes to me unless the Father draws them. We answered the call. We said yes. Just as Jesus told the parable of a man who had two sons, and he said to the oldest son, this Israel he's talking about, go and work in my vineyard. And the oldest son said, okay, I will. And then he didn't. See, Israel promised at Mount Sinai when the Ten Commandments was given that they would obey God. That's what Jesus is talking about. The disciples even said, didn't you know the Pharisees know you're talking about them? The people in the temple, it's during the Passion Week of Christ. Jesus said, a man had two sons. He said to the first son, go work in my vineyard. And he said, okay, I will. And then he didn't. Then he had a second son. It's us. Go work in my temple. And he said, no. Go work in my vineyard. And the second son said, no. But later on, he changed his mind and decided to obey his father and went and did it. Which one of those two sons did what the father asked? That was the second son. That's the church. That parable is about Israel versus the church. That's why Jesus said this kingdom, Matthew chapter 22 and 23, he said, that's why the kingdom will be taken from you and given to those who will bear fruit. Who bears fruit? That's why Jesus cursed the fig tree. Symbolic of Israel. No fruit on it, therefore I curse you. So what? Who became that? What does it say back there with Moses? What's the prophecy from Moses? There's a people that were not a nation, who has become a nation, a peculiar people. God had chosen Israel to become that holy nation, a peculiar people, but they would not. They rejected it. They told Moses, no, we don't want to go talk to God. You talk to God. You be our mediator. Go talk to God. We don't want to talk to God. We're afraid. They rejected their calling. They did not bear the fruit that God called them to do. So what happened? God chose the Gentile church, brothers and sisters, in the church age to bear the fruit. Israel's time is coming. They will receive the rewards of their lack of bearing fruit. They were scattered in the diaspora in 70 AD. The Lord gave them one generation from 31 AD until about AD 70 to turn to Him, but they did not. So He stopped their system of sacrifices because of blaspheme to the blood of Jesus. They were scattered in AD 70. Now, in these last days, the Lord is restoring Israel. So why? That He might contend with them for the faith through the war of Gog and Magog. Ezekiel 38 and 39, we see that. Why is God doing that? To show the world there is a God in Israel. That's why He's going to destroy the Russians. 5-6, as the King James says, 5 out of 6 of the Russian and the Persian and all those armies will be destroyed at the Battle of Gog and Magog. God will do it Himself. Why? To show there is a God in Israel. The tribulation period is for what purpose? It's called the time of Jacob's trouble. Yahweh's strange work. Why is that? That Israel may come to a saving knowledge of Yeshua HaMashiach. It's their Mashiach. Not just our Mashiach, but their Messiah. Zechariah 12:10. The Lord said, in those days I will pour out a spirit of prayer and supplication upon the house of Israel and upon the house of David. Hallelujah. That they will mourn for the one they pierced as one mourneth for a firstborn son. God's going to lead them to repent when they see Jesus coming back. As a matter of fact, you go study the scriptures and study it out, you'll see that the Lord returns to the mountain of Aholibamah, also known as Bozra, also known as Petra. The Lord will appear in the air to the Israelites who fled to the desert. Revelation chapter 12, that's the fulfillment of Revelation chapter 12. The nation of Israel will flee to Petra. That's where they'll be, and the Lord will appear. That's called Bozra in the old, you know, from the Bible also. He will appear to them there in the air, and then they will see it's Him. They'll mourn for the one they pierced. They'll look upon Him. They will receive Jesus at that moment. Many of those who are there in Petra, then the Lord will go to the Mount of Olives and land. The mountain will, the valley will split in twain, and He'll walk in there to the Temple Mount and rule and reign for 1,000 years. And the Israelites will go there. Hallelujah to Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Praise God. That's a whole other thing. It is finished, brothers. I just laid out just a quick different little piece of theology there for you, brothers and sisters, of eschatology. End time study is known as eschatology. That's the theological term for it, brothers and sisters. Praise God. We know from the Word of God that it is finished. Jesus paid it all for us, brothers and sisters. That's what I'm trying to convey to you. There's a difference between Israel and us until the end. Hallelujah. They have not yet received their Messiah as who He is, and they have not received redemption through the blood of Jesus, but we have. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus speaks a better word than the blood of Abel, the book of Hebrews tells us. Thank God. The blood of Abel spoke death and murder, but the blood of Yeshua speaks life, life eternal. Hallelujah. Praise God for that, brothers and sisters. Jesus paid it all for us. So remember that. Jesus paid it all. Now all to Him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's worship Him. Let's praise Him. Let's pray right now. Father, I ask You to bless Your people again, Lord. Bless Your people, Lord, who are watching this video. Lord, I pray for everyone who watches this video that they will receive salvation if they're not saved, if they're not born again, as You said, Lord Jesus. John 3:3, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Lord, let them see the light of Your salvation. As You said, You are the way, the truth, and the life. You said You are the light of the world. Let them see the light of Your gospel, Lord Jesus. Lord, let there be light into the hearts and minds of every person that sees this video right now in the name of Jesus, that they will know You as Lord and Savior, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we give You the praise and glory right now in the name of Jesus. every person watching this, if you're not sure of your salvation. As I quoted you earlier from Romans chapter 8, it says His Spirit will bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God. So you've got to do like Jacob did. He wrestled with God. He wrestled with the angel of the Lord until he knew that he knew that he knew that his name had been changed from those supplanter. Jacob means a supplanter or a heel grabber. He had supplanted his older brother, Esau. And he had become he who wrestles with God and man and overcomes. His name was changed by the angel of the Lord to Israel from Jacob. Changed to he who wrestles with God and man and overcomes. Hallelujah. Have you wrestled with the Lord? Have you contended with the Lord for your salvation? Hallelujah. Just like Nicodemus did when he came that night. He faced the Lord and discussed it with him. Hallelujah. That you know, that you know, that you know. By the Spirit of God in your spirit, that you are a child of God. I challenge you right now to pray. Let's pray. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, if there's anybody watching this who's unsure, if they are born again, Lord, hallelujah, we come in agreement, Lord, that you would show them, Lord, in their heart. Lord, as you do to so many hundreds or thousands of people I've talked to, through dreams, through visions, through peace, even as your word says, let the peace of God rule your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Lord, I ask you to fill them with peace and confirmation and understanding via dreams, visions, any way you will, Lord. Lord, because I know you customize your visitations to all your children, Lord God, in a way they can understand, hallelujah, that they'll know that they know that they know beyond a shadow of a doubt that when they die, they're going to heaven. Hallelujah, Father. I pray that they will contend until they find out, that they won't give up, they won't back down. For your word said, you said, Lord Jesus, the violent take it by force. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. That's true. The Lord said the kingdom of heaven is forcefully advancing from the time of John the Baptist until now, and the violent take it by force. Brothers and sisters, it's a war. It's a battle for our souls. The devil wants us to go to hell. The devil wants us to be deceived. The devil is a liar. As Jesus said, and the father thereof. He was a liar from the beginning, and he continues to lie and deceive as he did Eve. He told Eve, and you can become like God if you eat that fruit. The devil's always lying. The Antichrist is just going to keep carrying that to the next level. But in the meantime, brothers and sisters, we got to cut through all the noise to the simple truth. Very simple. Jesus said you got to become like a little child in order to enter the kingdom of heaven. And all these people talking about you got to keep the feast and do that and the other, all they're doing is try to heap heavy burdens on your back. Even as Jesus said about the Pharisees. They block the kingdom of heaven. They won't enter and they block other people from entering. That's what they do. They make people twice the child of hell that they are. Them old Pharisee people. Don't let them put religion on you, brothers and sisters. It's simply come to Jesus by faith. Hallelujah. As they say, you know, there's those songs, you know. Let's see. Just as I am. Just as I am without one plea. Oh, that thy blood was shed for me. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, hallelujah. Lamb of God, I come. Yes, you come to the Lord just as you are. Just as I am without one plea. Yes, but that thy blood was shed for me. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling for you and for me. Come home today. Those who are weary, come home. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes, all those songs are good songs. I can't remember all the lyrics, but they're awesome. Altar call songs. Just as I am. And softly and tenderly. Great songs. Great altar call songs. Praise God. May the Lord touch the hearts of everyone that watches this video, that you'll come clean of all this religion, all these traditions of men, and just come as you are to the Lord Jesus Christ. I mean, you just got to be like Adam and Eve. You got to get, you're naked. You're poor, blind, and naked, as the Lord told the end times church, the Laodicean lukewarm church. You think you're rich, but you're not. But you're poor, blind, and naked. You know, Adam and Eve tried to cover their nakedness with a fig leaf. And that's what religion is. It's a fig leaf. And the Lord says, come to me just as you are. You just, the Lord already sees your nakedness. He already sees your sin. He knows your shame and everything you're trying to cover up. The best thing to do is just, I mean, the Lord created us. He knows everything. The best thing to do is humble yourself. God gives grace to the humble, but He resists the proud. So come on, bended knee. And just as you are. Hallelujah. Jesus wants you just the way you are. He's the one to clean you up. You don't get cleaned up to come to Jesus. Jesus is the one that cleans us up. If we could clean up ourselves, then we wouldn't need Jesus. Hallelujah. It's just that simple. It's just that simple. Jesus paid it all. Not 90%, not 75%, but He paid it all. Jesus paid it all. Now all to Him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain. He washed it white as snow. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I pray that you be found in Christ today. That you're hidden in Christ today. May you be hidden in Christ today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because He's calling you. He's calling you. Today is the day of salvation. Hallelujah. He sought you and He bought you. Hallelujah. He's already paid the price in His precious blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He shed His blood on the cross for us. He didn't do it for Himself. He didn't need it, brothers and sisters. Jesus didn't need to get saved. We do. The Bible says God already showed how much He loves us while we were yet sinners. Christ died for us. Jesus died on the cross. Anybody, whosoever, as Jesus said. John 3:16, whosoever. One of my favorite words. That's one great reason to use the King James is for that awesome word. Whomsoever. Whosoever. Anybody. Hallelujah. Just anybody. Anybody. We can come to the cross. Hallelujah. We can be redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. We have to surrender our Godship over ourselves. We got to get off the throne of our hearts so that Jesus might get on the throne of our hearts. Many people sit on the throne of their own heart and they will not surrender all to Jesus. They're their own God. You know, they say, well, you know, money's his God. You know, pornography is his God. Alcohol is his God. Drugs is his God. No. They're their own God. Those are the things they take pleasure in. And they rule and reign in those pleasures. As the Bible says, sin has pleasure for a season. But the Bible also says, be sure that your sin will find you out. Oh, there's a day of judgment, a day of accountability. And you don't want to be on the wrong side of the cross. People talk the wrong side of the law. You don't want to be on the wrong side of the cross on judgment day. Hallelujah. You want to be at the judgment seat of Christ, not at the great white throne judgment. You don't want to be cast into hell. You don't want Jesus to say to you, depart from me, I never knew you, you worker of iniquity. You want Jesus to say to you, enter into thy rest, my good and faithful servant. Hallelujah. That's what you want to hear. Hallelujah. That's going to be a great day. What a day, glorious day that will be. Hallelujah. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. When He takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. What a day that will be. Oh yes, when my Jesus I shall see. Oh, what a day, glorious day that shall be. Oh, it's going to be a day. Hallelujah. I'm hoping to see all you guys there. We're going to be there together. We're going to be eating. And you know that's what Christians love to eat. That's why, because we're going to be breaking bread with the Lord. Can you imagine? I bet that's some good bread. If the Lord gives it to us, it's going to be good. Hallelujah. We're going to be breaking bread with the Lord. I'm sure they got all kinds of food there. We're going to be enjoying it. We're going to be at the great buffet in the sky. It's buffet. But there's a guy I used to know. He's a brother in the Lord, a Methodist. He calls it a buffet. He said, I went to the buffet. Yeah. Hallelujah. Or the buffet. The buffet or the buffet. But the great buffet in the sky. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I think he kind of had a little, there's a friend of mine, I think he's a Cajun. I think it's his Cajun way of saying it. Maybe. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I'm sure there's going to be some good Cajun food in heaven too and all those things. It's going to be a great time in the Lord, brothers and sisters. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait. to be there at the marriage supper of the Lamb with many of you. And we're going to have such a great time. There's going to be no sickness. There's no sorrows there. Hallelujah. What a day that will be. There's no sorrow and no pain. The song talks about that. What a day that will be. No sickness, no sorrow, no pain. Hallelujah. We'll all be free from fear and sorrow and pain and sickness and disease. Hallelujah. We're going to be walking those golden streets. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Praise God. It's going to be awesome. You know, that reminds me of a joke I used to tell when I first started in the ministry. There's a man who died, and the Lord, he was a good guy. He was a rich guy, and he was a good guy. And the Lord said, he was a billionaire guy that was actually a good man. And he told the angels who came to get him and said, "Can you please ask the Lord if I can bring one thing to heaven with me? I just want to bring one thing to heaven." And the Lord said, "Because you've been such a great guy, you know, a great Christian and a great servant of mine, yes, you can bring one thing to heaven." The guy said, "I want to take a suitcase full of gold." And he asked the angels to help him carry a suitcase full of his gold coins that he had been collecting all of his life to heaven. So when he got to heaven with those two angels, he had a suitcase. And St. Peter there at the gate, as they say, you know, St. Peter said, "What do you got in the suitcase?" And opened it up, and it's full of coins. And St. Peter started laughing and said, "Ha ha ha, you brought pavement." You got to bring one thing from earth and you brought pavement. I mean, you know, there's plenty of gold. The streets are paved with gold. I mean, gold is nothing in heaven. It's something that we'll walk on. That's what earthly gold is worth in heaven, brothers and sisters. Think about it. There's nothing in this world. Hallelujah. This, as the song says, "This world has nothing for me. I will follow you." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, he's more precious than silver. Lord, you are more beautiful than diamonds. Hallelujah. That's a song. I haven't heard that song in a long time. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. God bless you. Oh, I'm just, when I think about the Lord, how he picked me up and he turned me around and he placed my feet on solid ground, hallelujah, makes me want to shout, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Lord, you're worthy for all of the glory and all of the honor and all of the praise. Yes, makes me want to shout, hallelujah. I'm going to shout to the Lord. All the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, hallelujah. Glory to his name. Shout to the Lord. Praise his name. God bless you all, brothers and sisters. Hope you all have a blessed day. I will be back. I'll be in Vancouver one day only, June 15th. I will be able to meet people in Vancouver one day only on my way back through to North Carolina and on my way to Fort Worth, Texas. Hallelujah. There in June. God bless you all, brothers and sisters. Please let me know if you'll be able to meet me in Vancouver so I can give you a scheduled time. Let's work it out. God bless you all.